Breakfast is proudly brought to you by the Jetstar 50. Get more out of your weekend with Jetstar's 50 must-do experiences. Find yours at jetstar.com/50.
It's Monday, October the 31st. Kia ora, lovely to have you with us. Jack's gone back to the US to cover the election for us. So Daniel has moved to my left. Welcome.
Thank you, Hilary. Thanks for having me. Morena, this is Breakfast and it's 6 o'clock.
A huge earthquake has just struck central Italy, forcing residents to flee their homes as buildings crumbled. The 6.6 quake saw plenty of people hurt. And now the hunt is on for anyone trapped in the rubble. We'll be right across this story this morning.
As Hillary mentioned, we're off to the US, where the build-up to the election is getting feverish. Hillary Clinton's come out swinging over the FBI email investigation, while Donald Trump starts to make ground in the polls. Our very own Jack Tame will be with us live from New York.
Plus, fireworks season is back upon us. You all excited?
There we go again.
Yeah, whoa. And with it, fresh calls to ban private sales. We'd love to hear what you think about it. The SPCA's here with their plan of attack, this Guy Fawkes.
All right, Hillary, can you handle this?
I don't know, Daniel, can you handle this?
Yes, brace yourselves. Destiny's Child could be getting back together. We're live to Hollywood for details.
Big call. Right now at 6 o'clock, time for Melissa with the news.
Good morning. The strongest quake to hit Italy in decades has injured at least 20 people. A two-year-old boy fell from a window while his parents were out. A neighbour who saw what happened scaled the building with his bare hands, lifting the little boy down safely with just one hand.
Wow.
Where were his parents? Where were his parents? 6 past 6. I'll be back shortly with the news headlines.
Nice one. Let's go and have a look at the weather, because today is looking very promising. It's our last little ribbon of high pressure before the next front comes on. And this is what it looks like. The only real trouble zone today is that southerly flow. See the bubbly shower cloud? That's some cold stuff pushing some showers onto that east coast, and a bit of debris sliding up through Coromandel as well. The rest of us looking pretty good under clear skies. Yes, a little bit ominous out here, and that folds over us over the next couple of days. But today's good. High pressure centralised and perfectly placed. As you can see, as this front advances, we'll just start to see a little bit of high cloud and that northerly pick up over the bottom of the country. The rest of us looking pretty nice today. So I'll show you the showers around the outside of this high pressure. So anti-cyclone, so anti-clockwise rotation. Here's the showers folding into the eastern coastline. Wellington gets a little bit of a splattering as well, and you can just see them offshore through Coromandel, Auckland and over Northland as well, but it is mostly out to sea at this stage. So to the bottom of the country, it's frosty, it's fine this morning. In fact, it's a glorious day, but once again, those northerlies pick up and temperatures go with it. So you get a frosty morning, but a warm afternoon. Up the west coast, it's pretty good to begin with as well. A little bit more cloud with the advance of the front into the afternoon, but Nelson should survive in respect to that, but a bit of moisture pushing into Milford Sound by the end of the day as that front approaches. The east coast is glorious, and these starting temperatures, threes and fours, you can knock a couple off. That's a bit colder than what we originally went for, but it's a beautiful day, 15 in Christchurch. So just that cooler air flooding and keeping those highs relatively low. And that colder air is actually flooding into the North Island, so you can drop about 3 or 4 off these temperatures as well. A few showers into Gisborne. Hawke's Bay becoming fine into the afternoon, 15 with light winds. Switch back to the other coast, and it's lovely through here as well. You're away from any kind of cloud. The day's looking glorious. Just a little southerly pushing into the capital by the afternoon. So only 14 there, but fine. And as we head onto the central plateau, you've got some converging winds today. So you get a little bit of morning cloud into the afternoon. We get some showers, potentially some heavy falls. And over the top of the country, we saw those showers kind of just grazing Whitianga into Northland. So you see the showers pop up into the afternoon. Auckland could get a splash, but it's not going to be a bad day by any means. The story Melissa missed in the news this morning, Prince Harry...
Yeah.
Is apparently dating...
You're all over this, Sam.
I am all over this. My celebrity crush, Meghan Markle from
Suits is very upset.
She's,
really?
Yeah.
Are they, like, seriously dating?
Well, it's Hilary. We don't really know, but...
They've been spotted wearing the same bracelet.
Get out.
Yeah.
He's real. And they've, must be serious.
They've recently met, and then all of a sudden she's wearing his bracelet.
His bracelet.
Oh, well, that's it then, isn't it?
That's a real sign there.
They sound like a couple of teenagers.
Yeah.
I have no idea who this lady is. I need to Google.
Yeah, no, yeah. You need to watch Suits. That is a good show.
Yeah,
thank you so much, Sam.
Pleasure.
And Brody, I'm so excited because North Harbour won! We're back in the first division.
I know. I thought of you on Friday night.
Premiership.
The Premiership.
We're in the Premiership.
pressure.
I call it the first division.
I know. I thought of you, and I was so proud for you that they got promoted to the big.
Beside yourself.
Tears in your eyes, Brian.
Yeah, I know. I'm so happy. I thought, that's nice. And then another news: Canterbury won
the one.
Oh yeah. Whatever.
Yeah. But we've got some good news since 1908.
Oh, well, I tell you what, that won't inspire you to win that sort of singing.
It wouldn't.
Do you know what else wouldn't inspire me? This lotto ticket, which did not win me millions of dollars on the weekend.
But hang on a minute. Sucks. But no one won, so it's okay.
I know, but I did, at the local shop
and you put it in to win the $50 scratchy and now you've lost that chance.
No, I'm really depressed. I thought the money was mine. No, I'm going to buy one this week.
I get so depressed when I don't win.
See, I bought mine in Hunterville on Friday because that's what you do.
Yeah.
You buy them in random places.
No, I have to buy mine at the same place because it's superstitious. And what happens if they win one week and they haven't bought from there?
Well, that's true, but Brady's right. It's always these little rural places. It
always seems to be Te Awamutu.
Anyway.
Every time I go and check my ticket, I always say to the operator, can I just sit down before you tell me? Never win a thing. Never win a thing.
Anyway, plenty more on that. Also, a massive earthquake rocks Italy, sending residents fleeing as buildings crumble. With the latest in 10 minutes, plus John Key's back from his mission to India. So what happens now? Political reporter Katie Bradford fills us in on how successful the trip was once they finally got there. Some just want to watch it well burn, but some on the straight and narrow lost first turn. So before you play, take a page. Good morning, you're back with breakfast. It's 20 past six to the traffic now and it's building on the southern back at Drury. And then there's another heavy patch near Prince's Street. On the northern, it's heavy at Greville, then again between Esmond and Oniwa Road. And a big day in Christchurch. The first scheduled landing of the Airbus A380 at Christchurch Airport means the end of Grays Road and Avonhead Road will be closed from 10:30 a.m. to 2 p.m. today. And if you want to be there for the action, a viewing area can be accessed from Pound Road.
The Caltex Traffic Report, helping you enjoy the journey.
Italy is reeling after its fourth strong earthquake. I don't know who's gonna kiss you when I'm
gone, so I'm gonna love you now. Good morning, you're back with breakfast. It's 6:30, time for Melissa with the news.
Good morning, towns and villages.
There's just over a week to go until the US election.
There's absolutely no way.
Oh, here we go.
Hang on, Jack. I'm just reading my intro. You've got to wait. And honestly, you couldn't make up a juicier build-up.
I shaved first thing this morning. Scott, don't worry about the US election. Let's stick with facial hair. Here's the thing about my facial hair, and this is something they never teach you when you're doing, you know, like your standard two puberty class, all of that. So my face, right, almost grows no facial hair whatsoever. It's honestly, that's clean as. But my neck, just the amount of hair that grows on my neck, I didn't even know that was a thing. Yeah, and it's very difficult to shave your neck.
Neck hair.
So there we go. We're all learning. Ew. Honestly, if I pulled a Sam over the next 30 days or so, it would be absolutely grim. But anyway, Daniel, feel free to grow a moustache in place.
You've come
one of the things I'm
last
sure,
week. You were here in New Zealand. Now you're in New York.
Our viewers will be enjoying in my absence.
Magic, Jack. Magic. How's it going there, bud? What's it like being back?
I'm glad to see that you are making yourself right at home, actually, Daniel. It's good to see. No, it's been a funny time to arrive.
We're talking to you in the next hour, so this election's
Hi, Jack.
Hilary saying hi.
Lovely to see you. Daniel is settling right
hi.
In.
Hi.
And can I say how lovely it is
for me to work with three such
kind, caring men, so respectful of women. Just spare a thought for other women who are turning up on other breakfast shows this morning who don't get to work with guys like you. Enough said. Fireworks go on sale this week ahead of Guy Fawkes on Saturday, or as pet owners know it, the most irritating night of the year. So is it finally time to ban the private sale of fireworks? We'd love to know what you think. Send your emails to breakfast at tvnz.co.nz. That discussion before 7.
Number 28 on the Jetstar 50. Get on your bike and ride the Big Easy through the beautiful cycle trails of the Hawke's Bay. Get more out of your weekend with Jetstar's 50 must-do experiences. Find yours at jetstar.com/50.
It's Monday. Kia ora, lovely to have you with us. Jack's gone back to the US for the election, so Daniel's sitting in. Yeah. Welcome.
Thank you. Thanks for having me. Morena, this is breakfast, and it's 7 o'clock.
Just ahead, the strongest earthquake in decades has struck central Italy. The 6.6 magnitude quake forced residents to flee their homes as buildings crumbled. And now a search for possible victims trapped in rubble has begun.
The SPCA says it's time for a blanket ban on the private sale of fireworks. But are they just being party poopers? We get the Prime Minister's take on the issue. That's in 5 minutes.
And I might be a bit down that Daniel's cutting my lunch, but count them out, guys. 9 days to the US election. Can't wait.
Neither can we. Halloween has hit Hollywood and naturally the stars are taking fancy. He didn't look that excited, did he?
No.
Naturally the stars are taking fancy dress to a whole new level. I'm gonna fly like a bird overnight. Feel my tears. So which A-lister is under this wig will reveal all right before 8. Right now though, it's 7 o'clock, time for Melissa with the news.
The strongest quank.
It's Monday, October the 31st. Kia ora, lovely to have you with us. Jack's in the States for the election, so Daniel has moved seats. Welcome.
Thank you. Keeping the seat warm. Good morning, Morena. This is breakfast. It's 8 o'clock.
Just ahead, the sun's finally shining for most of us, so is it time to whip out the sunscreen? Or are we okay to sit back and soak up the vitamin D before the rays get too strong? Dr. John is here to tell us in 10 minutes.
Men of New Zealand, it's time to let it all grow out. Right, Sam?
That's right.
Yeah. Yamo, that is. Sam's gearing up to take part in Movember and is letting us choose his style.
Yay. Plus, another day, another chapter in the tragic Taylor Swift love story. Tay-Tay, how about some time on your own, girlfriend? Which fellow A-lister is she dating now? You won't guess this one. Excuse me, we'll tell you before 9. Right, it's 8 o'clock.
Motalk.
Oh, sorry, excuse me, I'm just going to have a cough. Sam,
have a cough.
You need to tell us about your growing your mo.
What do you want to know? historically, while you're choking, I've done the handlebar one. So that one, I think we need to get creative.
You've got to go hipster, I think.
Do you reckon hipster?
Hipster, change your whole look.
We like the hipster. We would quite like this one.
Are you allowed to go to bed for...
No, that's not a mo.
Okay.
No.
Yes. All right.
I like this one because I'd like you to see you wax it up every day.
See, I don't know if I could get... Because that's some good growth to get a curl on the end. I don't know if we could get that far, though.
No, you could definitely do that.
Yeah.
You've got some good growth going already.
Goals, Sam.
Okay, so shall I quickly just show you the other ones as well?
The Magnum PI.
Yeah. That's quite good.
I quite like that.
Yeah.
But you can do that easy.
You look very handsome.
Hang on. For the Charlie.
This one, I think, is quite funny. This is I work for the fire service, Sam.
Okay.
Yeah. Fireman Sam.
Fireman Sam.
Yeah. So which one do you like? Let us know. Breakfast at tvnz.co. Hipster, Fireman Sam, or Magnum PI? okay, we're right on 8 o'clock. Time for Melissa with the news.
It's been revealed the FBI was advised by the US Justice Department not
We've got someone else that's making a bit of a contribution as well. We're going to take you now behind the scenes. Come on, Bundy.
We're on.
Yeah, come on, mate. You come through. See, we've got some. We've got a bit of work for you. Now, this is our control room. So we've got. Kelly over here on this desk.
Somebody just hit
our lineup producer over here. This is Sophie over here. Simon pushing the buttons. Oh, come on, turn around, Simon.
Oh.
Come on, everyone wants to see who pushes the buttons.
Hi, Simon.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, this is Shiga. I don't know what Shiga does.
She yells at us.
What are you doing?
Go away.
And over here is Ryan. Now, I actually don't know what Ryan looks like, which is an interesting thing. So come over here. You don't want to shave it off now, but you are going to.
I will. So, I will. At the end.
Why do you want?
If he comes back in.
Why do you want to save it for another month? It's been going on long enough.
It's been going on a year and a half, 2 years, mate.
Okay, so will you be a part of my team then? We'll do this together, and you can also help us reveal Ryan to find out if he has a weak chin. Find out what he's hiding.
What's beneath that?
Would you be able to get through this?
I'll do it.
Yeah,
oh. You're on. Oh, sweet mate. Thank you.
Oh, it's a broness.
It's the bro love. Yeah.
I love it. I cannot wait for this. And thank you so much for embracing the Batmo.
Yeah, all right. We'll go tie that up now.
Super
come
excited.
On.
Fantastic. Thanks, guys. Well, that is all from us this morning. We'll be back tomorrow morning. Lovely to have your company
thank
today,
you.
Daniel.
Thank you.
And, of course, Brody, who's still with us on the desk. Not to forget Brody. We're going to leave you to ponder this question right now. Will Destiny's Child get back together? Enjoy the beats. See you tomorrow.
See you. Bye.